Still waiting on Democratic Congresswoman Omar and Tlaib and their news conference on travel restrictions to Israel. We will bring it to you live. But first, this.
I disagree with President Trump that the economy is strong for everyone and that the fake news of America today is somehow misleading the American people.
It's nice to see the media finally cover the Trump economy. You seem to cover it only when you can use the Sesame Street word of the day, recession. And so you're using a tweet here, a report there, or an economist's words here and there. The fact is the fundamentals of our economy are very strong, and you know it.
Well, let's just say they agree to disagree. Democrats warning of a recession, the White House telling them to cool it. And according to a new survey of top economists, about one-third do see a recession in 2021. But get this, the number of economists who think a recession is coming this year or during the 2020 election year actually going down. So what do we make of all this? Let's ask our money and market watchers, Jonathan Honig, Jonas Max Ferris, and Melissa Armo. Melissa, let me start with you. What do you make of all of it?
Well, as far as recession of the market, because it's two different things. You can have a strong economy and you can have a weak market. You can also have a weak economy and a strong market.
Well,
so they're
one
not
do we
necessarily
have now?
The same. Well, right now, I do think that we have a strong economy and we actually have a strong market. So we have the best of both worlds right now. Even though the market has been very volatile lately, the market is still in an uptrend and it's still holding. But expect that this volatility will continue. You'll have days that will rally like today, and then we may sell off another day. And you may have to remember, the market is about perception. So people buy and sell stocks and the market based on perception. Are we going to go into recession? Could create the fear that people sell, even if we don't. Just
right.
The same thing with China. People think we might have a deal with China in the next month, but we could rally on that, but we don't.
Jonathan?
I disagree with that, Charles. The market isn't like a spouse. You can't talk it into something. It is what it is. And look, the fact is people are talking about recessions for very legitimate reasons. Everything from a multi-week decline in a stock market, still a majority of stocks are below their 200-day moving average, to that inverted yield curve. And I'll tell you what, the market is the best indicator, Charles. Think back to 2001, that recession. The market started falling in March of 2000. We didn't call it a recession till a year later. Same thing in 2007 and 2008. So watch the stock market. If its decline continues, a recession is almost baked in.
Although about 450 of the S&P 500 companies are up this year. And by the way, in February, 52% of the country's top economists said, yeah, recession between now and the end of next year. That number is down to 40% since February. So it's interesting, Jonas. Also, this brings us to the President Trump's favorite topic, and that's the Federal Reserve. He just tweeted earlier, this is part of it. Our economy varies.